So today I want to talk to you about generating attraction using conversation. I get a lot of emails from men where they tell me that they don't know what kind of things they should be talking to women about, or I get emails where they express their frustration that they'll meet a woman, they'll talk to her for a while, and at the end of the night they'll barely get her phone number and she rarely returns the phone calls, or they'll set up a date and the woman never shows up on the date. So today I'm going to tell you why is this happening and what you can do, what kind of style of conversation you should be using to get different results. You see, what happens is most men naturally, they feel that getting women or, you know, generating attraction is a lot of work, that you need to be doing a lot of stuff before attraction happens. So they think, you know, sometimes they falsely assume that they're not good enough, so they need to try hard, do more things before a woman's going to change her mind. Or sometimes they think just the natural process involves that I need to do these 10, 15, 20 things before a woman's going to like me, before the attraction happens, you know. An example would be a lot of the men, when they go out, they assume that, oh, I need to have a very engaging interaction. I need to have some really cool opener. When I start talking to a woman, I need to make her laugh. I need to give her a compliment. I need to touch her. I need to go for a kiss. So they have this list of 8 or 10 things that they think that if they can execute that successfully one after another, that somehow magically attraction is going to happen. And this strategy usually backfires. And the reason it backfires is, you know, women have two sides to them. They have this one social side to them, and then they have this deep inner feminine side to them that they're rarely exposed to men. And the reason they're rarely exposed that is, you know, that makes them vulnerable, and that opens them, exposes them to getting hurt. So the only people who see that feminine side of women are people who she actually likes or she actually trusts. That could be her dad, her brother, her boyfriend, her husband, her children. Most of the other people, she always engages on the social level, because women from childhood are programmed to interact with men on the social level. They know that when they leave the house, you know, a lot of men will try to do favors to them just to sleep with them. They know that when they go out, they're supposed to be polite, they're supposed to be more accepting of men. So when women go out and they talk to you, most men assume that women are engaging them, but what's happening is it's a one-sided conversation that happens 90% of the time. Because the guy will go out and he will start executing his conversation pieces, he's making her laugh, he's making, you know, doing all that stuff. But this woman is only engaging on the social level. She's just being polite. She's just letting it happen because she's just used to it, and she's not engaging on a deep emotional level. And unless you do that, attraction will never happen. You know, an example is like when I go out, when I talk to women, I'm always concerned about where is this woman? How does she feel around me? You know, when she's interacting to me, what's going through her mind? What emotions is she experiencing? And my focus is all on, you know, on dropping her guards down, as opposed to executing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, because all that execution is not going to change anything. A perfect example would be this client of mine. He's part of my one-on-one training, and this guy has actually done 4 or 5 workshops from other companies before he came to me. And when he came to the workshop, the very first thing that I was seeing was like he was having such a strong conversation with women. Like it was a very, it was all routine. Like it was all like plotted out that I have to go out and I have to, you know, come on very strong. I have to have a very strong body language. Then I have to touch her right away. Then I have to do this. I have to say this. I have to have a very sexual conversation. And every time he would come out from the interaction, I would ask him, how did your interaction go? And it's like, oh, it went great. I was able to talk all this sexual stuff with her, and she accepted that. And see, what happens is, once again, for men, because most of their life they've not been able to have this style of conversation, they've not been able to talk sexual stuff with women they just meet. So they think that if I'm able to do that, I'm making progress. That if a woman was sitting there and she allowed me to just have this sexual conversation and she let me touch her, that maybe there is something between me and her, that maybe I'm a confident guy, that she's okay me getting sexual with her. And if I keep persisting, if I just do a little bit more, somehow attraction is going to happen. And this is a very, very bad strategy, because again, as I said, you're having a one-sided conversation, and the more you try, the more you don't realize that she's not reciprocating and you're persisting, the more you lose value in her eyes, the more she realizes you're not the kind of guy she wants to open up to. So the strategy at this point usually is that when you go out to meet women, you need to know how they're feeling and how what you need to do to take it to the next level. Every guy will make a woman feel different. When I go out and meet women, there is a different effect I have on women than you will have on women. So you need to know the first thing is what kind of effect you have on women. So for example, when I go out and talk to women, I have a very strong sexual presence. You know, I make very strong eye contact. I also am very comfortable with my distance and all with them. So it comes across as someone who's very sexually confident, but at the same time that I also know that that's intimidating to women because now they're wondering if this guy is a player, if he's reliable, can I connect with him? So my job is to bring their guards down, to become more reliable. So when I meet women, I make fun of myself. I make fun of my look. I drop my value down. Maybe I'll share something about my life that makes me come across as more reliable. So as a result, now all those doubts they have in their mind disappear. And then gradually they can open up. You know, when I'm talking to a woman and if I notice at first that they have their guards up, I'll use some self-deprecating humor that is just to convince them that, oh, you know, we can all relax and we can all put our guards down. If there comes a time I need to give her a compliment, I wouldn't just give her a compliment because once again, she's used to men giving her fake compliments. If I give her a compliment, my delivery will be very different than most other guys. I deliver it in a manner that's actually believable, that's actually, when she listens to it, she's like, wow, this guy really must appreciate this about me. So when fewer things like this happens, when, you know, I deliver 4 or 5 things where I can see how she's feeling and I can change how she feels about me, around me, then she will start to drop her guards. And once she drops her guards down, then I will be able to have that engaging emotional interaction with her. And that's when attraction happens. So when you go out, don't think you need to execute 10, 15 things. Don't think you need to have a series of activities that you need to execute one after another. What you need to know is, what effect do you have on women when you first meet them? And based on that, what are the next 3 or 4 things you need to do so she drops her guards and engages you on an emotional level? And the best thing for this to do is, you know, you can download the Social Mastery Home Study Course and you can go through all the emotional barriers. You can also see how, you know, the timing of how you execute your conversation pieces, your, you know, the elements of the conversation pieces that allows you to take control of the conversation and make a woman drop her guards. Or the best thing you can do is you can come to a workshop. The beauty about coming to a workshop is when you come to a workshop, you're not on your own. Now I'm watching you and I can tell you right away what effect you're having on women and what are the next 3 or 4 things you need to incorporate in your interaction so you start to get results. And once you're done with that workshop, once you know those 3 or 4 things you need to do and I teach you how to incorporate and the timing, you will have attraction every single time. So I really hope this information helps you and I'll talk to you soon.